And let's just jump right on the topic. So when it comes to Webflow, the first things that come in my mind actually is no code. And we have learned a lot about it during the past year, about no code, low code, no code tools. So the first thing that I wanted to ask you, Sarkis, was actually, what is no code? And ultimately, what is a no code tool?
Sweet. So first of all, let me start by saying what no code isn't. It is not a replacement for code. It is not a replacement for code. No code tools allow you to interact with code visually by clicking instead of typing. It's as simple as that. So it's more of an automation. You're automating processes that normally require a lot of typing, a lot of coding, programming, where now the same programming takes place in the background, but you're able to automate that and activate those codes by simply clicking.
Are there any tools that you would like to share with us to build a magical landing page? So if you have like three tools that you would like to share with us, maybe Sarkis, and then we'll go with Kevin.
Well, I don't know if you've noticed, but I'm a big fan of Webflow.
Yes.
So Webflow is primarily where I stick to. But I want to make an interesting point here. I feel like sometimes there's this zero-sum game being played, which is for Webflow to win, everyone else has to absolutely lose, which is not the case. There is a time and place for WordPress, for Wix, for Squarespace, for Card, for all these tools. There's also a great platform just raised $2.2 million in funding in Berlin, for example. You got Softer.io, that they really allow you to just very quickly create a landing page as well. So there are very good solutions out there. When it comes to Webflow, yes, you can have templates, you can really start well off, but it's more of, you kind of have to, it gives you a lot of possibilities that you may not need. So if you just want to launch your idea, you want to really get that instant traction as fast as possible, maybe Card is the best option for you to kind of get into no code for the first time. Or maybe Software would be a good option for you to kind of see how integrations plug into one another, how you can use Airtable to get, you know, your ideas out there.
I agree. I totally agree. We have that with the clients I meet also. So they've heard about no code. They've heard about, like you said, Bubble or Webflow, but the tool is not what will bring more business. It's just a tool, one more tool to just bring it more easier to the market. So the most important indeed is to know the need.
Do you open up flowbase.co, because their landing page, before we talk about no code mentor, is such a great experience too.
I love the website too.
Yes. A big shout out to
Yeah. So notice how, for me, a landing page is a product. It is not a dead end. It's not like the cover of a book. You know, people often like to use these metaphors. It is the product. If people have only 5 seconds of attention span to focus on your product, then that is your product. If you weren't able to sell it immediately and get their attention, you've already failed. There is no other product you're going to be going into. Now, notice how when you go into Flowbase, it immediately gets you the product. Here's what I can do for you. Here's something else I can do for you. And then it says, by the way, here's a little bit about me.
So Kevin has his nice approach. He also told me like authentic says best. And I think that's actually what his website is actually showing us right now.
So so before starting, so the website at start is in French and is translated in Weglot, with Weglot. I think you know the tool. Do you know it, Sarkis?
Weglot?
Weglot.
I've heard of it.
When you land on my website, so I'm selling a course, it's an online course, so it's different than a tool or a service. But what I said is like authentic sells best. So I just wanted to create kind of a relation with my visitors. So let's say they don't know me and they scroll down. And so, yeah, my targets are graphic designers who want to learn how to use Webflow. So I've been there before, so I know what were my problems. So I start with that, with the problems they have today. And so it's like a conversation. So you can scroll down. And then, so I talk about other tools, of course. And then with the training, they will get those results. So they will be able to build on Webflow, of course, with SEO, building something solid. They will have fun. They will take even bigger projects. And so, yeah, I started this page with the landing page, with the conversation, sorry. And so it's like a long, long sales page. You don't need to go straight to the bottom. But the goal here is just to be authentic, explain my story, where I went to, and of course, sharing them the solutions to how to get there too, because my goal is to share the word as much as possible, because it was a life changer for me, and I think it can be a life changer for other graphic designers who want to learn how to create websites.
So a website is a landing page. Can you please explain us a little bit more about this, about your approach?
Yeah, to not repeat myself, I would say think of your landing page as your product. That's what I'm trying to say. A website is a landing page and vice versa. Don't assume that the landing page leads me to the website or leads me to the product, because the person is not going to waste time. The person's going to look at that landing page and assume, make a decision. Do I want to continue or not? That's what it boils down to. So try to, again, if you look at no-code mentors and Flowbase, and by the way, could you please, Thomas, could you go to your own website, go to Weglot's website?
Yes, sure. Here it is.
Yeah, so immediately you're showing, you're giving me that visually, look at that. Visually, it's already showing you how easy it is to use this product, right? If you scroll down a little more, right? There we go, boom. It immediately starts to show you the value that's been created. It's not trying to tell you this long-winded story. And I love the, shout out to FinSuite, Joe Krug and the FinSuite team.
Yes.
Could we open up the website that they created real quick?
Sure, sir.
You launched this cloneable, this crazy cloneable in Webflow to tell the story of a multilingual website. And it immediately engaged everyone. It provided educational value. And then you said, by the way, this is how much we're charging for our product. So see, you already gave me so much. I mean, this type of a website is very difficult to build. This is no easy task. This takes a lot of time. For you to provide that value out of the gate, it shows a lot of integrity. It shows a lot of interest in the community.
So right now, I think we got a lot of questions. And the first question that I have, let's pick. Do you recommend Fiverr, Upwork to get clients? I'd like to start a freelance business doing web design with Webflow. It's a question from Luis.
Yeah, I think this is relating specifically to freelancing. So I would say for some people it works really well. For other people, not at all. One thing I've realized is you do not go to Fiverr Upwork to build relationships. But from my experience in the early days when I was using these tools, it always ends with, okay, a transaction, and then you go back to the C and try to find someone else. And I don't like that. I like to build relationships, which is what I've done in my experiences. First of all, create a set, 5 or 10 projects that are really unique, like no one else has done. Really think in the one of a kind. Don't try to be number one. If you're number one, it's a little better than everybody else. Try to be the only one, right? No one did a console in Webflow. No one did a game prototype, which is why I did that. It took extra time, but it paid off in the end, as opposed to I could have just created kind of like an e-commerce website or something, which would have been equally interesting, but not as unique. So if you're able to create that base, and then you can understand the unique aspects of what you're offering, you can go to these startups and these companies and you can sit down with their CEOs and founders who've been very open with me, for example. I've converted companies here in Chiang Mai, Thailand, where I'm based at the moment. I've converted these companies to, you know, there are 50, 100 people working there to Webflow.